and welcome to Set Up Darkroom TV. My name is Marie Pshamis, and of course today I'm gonna be talking about Britney Spears. Oh, I feel so sad even just mentioning her name, because I'm just one of those people who really love Britney Spears so much. You know, I loved her from the Oops, I Did It Again, I Played With Your Heart. Anyway, copyright infringement, I don't want to have that. So just recently Britney Spears was in the papers once again, because apparently she's having another mental breakdown. And you know, things have kind of like really changed for Britney. You know, I mean, things have been going downhill for a long time now. And you know, we all remember Britney's shaving off her head. And I was just saying, oh, that's very brave. She shaved off her head when she had the previous mental breakdown, and she was kind of like really hitting the paparazzi with the umbrellas, because she had enough of it, and she was just saying, leave me alone, leave me alone. And ever since that happened, Britney has been going through a lot of misfortune. And just recently her fans kind of like set up a page, and they were saying free Britney, because apparently people are alleging that Britney was put in a mental institution by force. And I was like thinking, oh, not again, here we go again. Because I actually, when I was watching Britney for some time back, I kind of like thought she was putting her life together, you know. And it's really, really sad to know that she's again going through the same mental breakdown. And I think when I was watching TMZ, they were saying that the medication that she was taking kind of like triggered the breakdown. And I was like thinking, oh my god, I hope this is not gonna be worse. I watched Britney try to put her life together, but you know, this demon that she has, you know, which is mental illness, is really allegedly the biggest case that she's having at the moment. And you know, Britney's always have some kind of conspiracy theories going on with her, you know, people. All right, my conspiracies, I had a little technical difficulty because my phone just kind of like went dead and in the middle of filming. Yeah, so I was talking about Britney Spears. I'll just carry on from what I was saying. You know, rumor has it that, you know, Britney Spears is under Illuminati. You know, people are always saying that, you know, all these problems that Britney Spears is going through is to do with Illuminati and mind control. And you know, it's really, really sad, because you know, people allege that, you know, Britney Spears, when she was I think a Mickey Mouse child, her parents sold her off to the Illuminati. So all this problem that she's going through is because she's going through under mind control. And it's really kind of really hard to dispute this, because you know, Britney Spears usually doesn't look like a person who is in control of her own life. You know, this woman, if you see Britney Spears, you can see that something is missing, especially me. You know, I'm kind of like a woman who kind of like to look at people in detail. And every time I was looking at Britney Spears, I kind of like always saw this lost soul. And some people are the reason why they kind of even started the, you know, the hashtag Free Britney Spears, because they actually blame Britney Spears' parents. They kind of like usually accuse them of, you know, using Britney. Because if you don't know the story of Britney, you know, Britney is a grown-up woman who is 37 years old, but she's not her own boss. Her parents are in charge of her money. And I'm just thinking, if my parents were in charge of my money at my age, they'll be spending it like hell. You know, I mean, black parents have got their ways as well. And in a way, some people kind of like that, you know, actually Britney Spears' parents are responsible for her, you know, for her finances. Because you know, you know what happened when she married, you know, Kelvin Federline, the guy who was also another Dusty, who didn't have a job. Was definitely, he had a, you know, come up when he was married to Britney, because he used her to have children and, you know, be having child support as a man. I just really find this reverse role where the men are more womanly. You know, the men nowadays are not men, you know, they're kind of like, men are so, the only thing that's missing is a pussy on them, because men are so womanly nowadays. You know, they're no longer providers. They're just waiting for women to kind of like provide for them. They're girls everywhere, you know, if you know what I mean. I mean, I'm just saying, you know, after the winter situation, you just have to be very careful. If you have a dusty man who's always depending on you, you really need to protect yourself, like maybe sign a prenup, because dustmen are just running around everywhere. And because of this dustmen, you know, taking advantage of Britney, I'm not surprised that her parents have the ownership of our, you know, of our finances, and they're responsible for her. And when I was, I think I was listening to TMZ just recently, TMZ said that, you know, this recent mental breakdown that Britney was having was triggered by her her medicines. Apparently, allegedly, I should say, she has bipolar, I think. And sometimes, you know, people who have bipolar tend to not want to take their medication. And when they stop taking their medication, that's when the shit hits the fan, man. That's when they go, whoo, crazy in the street, you know. And I just want Britney to really get well, and I hope, you know, the new medication they're gonna prescribe for her will be able to help her out. Because, you know, if you know Britney, she had a, you know, Vegas residence. She was supposed to be performing in Vegas. She canceled that because of this problem that she was going through. And it's really, really sad, because instead of her making money, she's always dealing with, you know, issues. It's either she's dealing with many issues, or she's dealing with financial issues, or she's dealing with mental breakdown issues. But I think, you know, she really needs to take care of her health, you know, because health is always important, especially considering that she has children. And as a mommy, I kind of like, really, I am in support of her. So I was just watching that video of Britney assuring her fans that all is well. The only thing that was distracting me was her hair and her makeup. You know, as women, when you like kind of like really in a state of nuts, you forget to take off your hair. So you can tell that her hair was a mess. Her makeup, I don't know, it's like someone just smeared a makeup on. I think she was literally forced to even make this video just to assure people that everything is fine. But I think I would urge Britney to really take care of herself and, you know, take her medications. And I know, I've heard actually from a lot of people who have bipolar or mental illnesses, they always blame the medications. They actually say that this medication that they, you know, subscribe for them usually cause them to feel drowsy, and, you know, they feel like, you know, they don't feel like, they feel like zombies, you know. So that's why, you know, you find that people like Kanye West, Britney Spears, they usually sometimes stop taking their medicine, and then they kind of like just have this, you know, mental episodes where they kind of like just go crazy. And yeah, so I'm just hoping that, you know, Britney Spears is gonna be fine. And she was out in the street wearing a nice white dress, you know, having a yogurt. I hope the yogurt is gonna help her fix her, you know, just to kind of like put a front that everything is fine. And I hope she's taking her medications just to make sure that she, that we don't have another episode of her cutting off her hair and, you know, beating people with an umbrella. Because that would be like bananas. Anyway, so that's the story that I wanted to share with you about Britney. What happened, that she literally had a mental breakdown this week. You guys are welcome to make suggestions in the comment section and tell us what you think about Britney. Do you think she was forced to go into a mental institution, or do you think it was really the best decision that parents made to kind of like really look after our welfare, so, you know, we don't have another episode of her, you know, having a mental breakdown in public? And it's really, really sad about what is happening. I don't even want to kind of like talk about this so much, because, you know, Britney used to be my favorite. Like, when I was growing up, I used to love Britney so much. Like, I was listening to all her music, and I was like literally one of our fans. I was like, you know, I used to love Britney, bitch. Anyway, let us know what in the comment section what you think about the Britney Spears mental breakdown, because I would love to hear from you guys. And of course, you know, the comment section is for you guys to make suggestions, bitch to me, or if you have something that pissed you off about what I said, express yourself, shout it out in the comment section. Anyway, that's what I had for you on the Britney stories. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.